cluster of verdant valleys at the northwestern tip of Pakistan, populated predominantly by the Khoi, who speak a melodious language, Khwar.
Gatherings of folk music are so integral to the Khoi that they say even a bag of leather can learn to dance.
Even as the sun sets, melodies from the traditional musical instruments of dhol, surna and the dandana can be heard rising from the valleys. The sounds of these instruments draws the people towards them.
Traditional Chitrali music, or Kuknus in the local language, is divided into 63 kinds of melodies. These melodies are divided into two categories, Dani and Sauz, which cover all existing Chitrali tunes.
An important cultural center on the left bank of the Chitral River is the settlement of Dhorosh, about 26 kilometers to the south of the city of Chitral. It is linked to the plains by the 3,200-meter-high Loaru Pass. Until the 13th century, Dhorosh had been an important place for the neighboring Kalash tribes, and their distinctive architecture has left its mark on the settlement. Apart from Khwar speakers, Dhorosh is a mosaic of tongues, including communities that speak Palora, Dumeli, Gojri, Pashto, and Farsi.
Strategic position also makes Dhorosh the headquarters of the local militia, the Chitral Scouts.
Whenever they take time off from the soldiering duties, they return to the world of dance and music. The spirited people of Chitral can dance traditional dances and sing folk songs the whole night through. The better among them displaying their prowess. Barwazi is a folk dance with a special tune reserved exclusively for it. People who dance it slowly enter into a trance and appear intoxicated. the dancer, dragging his long woolen cape, the choa, along the floor, while the onlookers loudly shout encouragement.
The song being presented is the story of an old man and an old woman. The old woman has had a tiff with the old man, and he is going out into the darkness of the night to bring her back.
Is the name in Khwal for a sword dance. The martial tune of Shangiwal is played for this dance.
One dancer has a sword in his hand. Two or more other dancers surround him while he exhibits his skill with a blade.